They tell me that we have 97 minutes here tonight, without intermission. So, meetings, anything, anybody? If you need to drink water or anything? You know, about a year ago, I drove Sally home from the dance. While we were standing up under the porch of the house, we looked down at the river. And we saw this silver flying thing fly straight up and zip off. When we came running down to the river, we saw the Japanese had landed some amazing new flying machines. But all we found was the boat house here, and that was enough. I'll just point out some of the facilities so everybody gets settled in. If everything goes well with me tonight, we should be a waltz. 1, 2, 3, 1. A no holds barred romantic story. And since I'm not the romantic type, I'm going to need the whole Valentine here to help me. Woods, willow, vine, moonlight, and there's a man that plays tonight over the park. Trees, berries, reeds, sounds, water. Lights, the bees working all night. Did you know that? Bees work, worker bees, all around the clock, never stop. Collecting nectar, pollen, whatever bee collect. Of course, their life expectancy is 20 days. Or in the case of a bee, 20 days and 20 nights. Or perhaps expectancy is wrong in the case of a bee and bee. Who knows what a bee expects? But whatever time there is in a life, I imagine after 20 days and 20 nights, if he is more or less ready to tuck in.
Out of the flying now, we on the sprout. But now I'm in a 19 days, 19 nights. Are you really going to have power for me? Well, I'm about ready to tuck in.
Work is very much to the point. We've got everything here to help me. There's a rotating gizmo in the footlights.
You believe some footlights?
Well, because we need the moon and the water out there. Oh, the river runs right through here, so you're all out in the water. Sorry about that. They promised me moonlight by the bale all through the shutters. We could do it on a couple of folding chairs. But it isn't there. It isn't bound out. And Valentine's need poo-poo. We have a genuine Victorian folly here, a boathouse, constructed of bluebirds and lettuces and gewgaws. And I feel like a real estate salesman. Something about that term real estate strikes me as wrong. I mean, a stage? Maybe, but real? Oh, it's early. Well, get you started on the right foot. Everybody ready? This is a waltz. There was a time. All right, I think that has to be once upon. There was a hope throughout the land. From the chaos of the Great Depression, people found strength in union, believing their time had come. But even as this hope was perceived, once again, a dark power rose from the chaos in another land. And once again, this nation pitched its industry and resources into battle. After about 3 years of battle, it became apparent that the war is turning. Once again, we are told that peace and prosperity are in the air. But in the midst of battle, that hope that people had known had been changed to the enemy. Peace, and more to the point, prosperity, was our ally. Once again, we are told that the country is the safe country. Now, you would think that in this remote wood, on this remote, unimportant, but sometimes capricious river, that world events would not touch this hidden place. But such is not the case. There is a house on the hill up there, and there is a family who is not at peace, but in grave danger of prosperity. There is a girl in the house on the hill who is a terrible embarrassment to her family because she hard to use your peripheral vision when you're being led by the nose. Now, worship. You're thinking, if I knew it was going to be like this, I wouldn't have come. Or if I knew it was going to be like this, I would have listened. But don't worry. Because we're going to do this first part all over again when late comes. I want to give you and me both every opportunity. So, okie dokie. Tell me if I'm from Michigan, I'm not in Michigan. I mean, didn't they basically get drink water or anything? I was proud of it, so they're very still. They have people looking at you, get water, like if you want to go over and ask you, so that'll make that a double share. The woods, the village, the ice, the village, the band, the benefit, whatever. The trees, the berries, the breeze, the sound, water, crickets, frogs, dogs, lions, the bees, the feminine, frogs. Now, we like a dog. We have a dog, please.
Thank you.
We had it consecrated as a church. And that worked for about 2 years when they called it. Churches don't pay taxes. We had it ordained. They didn't like it. So, we set up a trust fund in the name of David. Now they want to hear it on the opposite. We said, horses can't hold trusts. It was just as wrong. I said, they can say, Louis, wrong. It was crazy to come back early. I promised you.
Would you please?
Shelly, it's unimportant.
admire it.
I was there last February when you
Funny. One of the girls said you had a cold that day, and the other one said you had gone to Kansas City to requisition new beds. She was very imaginative, but under sympathetic questioning, she was not a good girl.
So you came all that way down to Springfield and all that way back for nothing.
It was not a wasted afternoon. I had the honor to be shown by a Negro private in California 25 different ways I can lose the game of checkers. Also, it gave me time to puzzle. Why would Sally tell everyone with whom she works that if this hairy Jewish accountant comes down like a crazy man to see her, everyone tell him she's not there and Sally will hide in
the
closet?
I was working in the kitchen that morning where visitors are not allowed. It was not necessary.
Well, the little nurse is coming in every 10 minutes to say, I don't know, Sally, he's still up there. Looks like he intends to stay all day. Puzzles. Don't waste my time. I'm very good at puzzles. I have great powers of ratiocination. I'm a regular Sherlock. He was a terrible anti-Semite. He was a very shallow, ignorant man. Did you know that?
I'm sorry, I wasn't listening. I was trying to figure out what ratiocination means.
Oh. Excuse me. I don't have a speaking vocabulary. I have a reading vocabulary. I don't talk that much.
I haven't noticed the problem.
Weren't you always saying how quiet I was last summer?
Nancy, why don't you say something?
Weren't you always asking me questions?
I retract everything I said last
summer. But unlike Sherlock, I'm not quick. I'm steady, and I stay with something. But I'm thick. First, it took me a long time to know something as thick as me. And then, going over the Sally in the Closet puzzle, it occurred to me what was called for was an on-the-spot investigation.
Ma'am,
so I have a few questions I'd like to put to you.
There is no mystery.
bash me and knock me down? I was only five. Some memories later.
In St. Louis?
In the winter, they would skate in the lake. Frozen solid. Had another boy skates on once. Nearly broke my neck. What I should have expected on that one, you call it beautifully coordinated individual.
Oh, don't put those...
That rollerbeak in Lebanon, where all the soldiers hang out? It seems like the principal recreation around here. Fellas and their dates.
Girls looking for soldiers.
Looks like they're having a good time. All that drinking and all that skating. I get sick.
They do.
Would you go?
I went once, Matt. I didn't like it. Now don't stand
up. No. It's all about balance. Unfortunately, I have no sense of balance at all.
Thank you.
mistakes when we came down here last summer. There never would have been an affair between Sally and...
There was no affair.
Well, of course there was an affair. How many times in 7 days did I see you?
I don't know.
Seven.
Seven.
Seven. I got hoarse screaming over the music in that dance band. I can hardly talk all week long.
The kids nowadays like it so loud, they don't have to think.
I don't blame them.
That is why.
You didn't mind talking to me on the porch of the Shriner's Mosque.
I didn't mind talking to you. I didn't mind you driving me home. I didn't even mind changing the tires.
Yeah, well, I thought we made a very good team. Most girls would have stayed in the car. You at least held the flashlight.
Held the flashlight?
Well, they told me how to change the tire.
And lit matches so you could see when the flashlight battery burned out. You could have done it much faster myself. What I minded was the very next evening and walking 2 miles.
I told you to stay in the car. I told you not to come.
What's someone going to say to me sitting alone in the car on a road where lovers park? I've never been before in my life.
I tried to hitchhike this ride. You'd hit in the bushes every time a car came by. I'm looking around for you. The driver's all getting gone drunk and they pull over into the lane. You almost caused three head-on collisions that night.
Aside from that night, the other times I saw you were a lot of fun. Except maybe the night you came to dinner.
Well, I am not responsible for your failure. That evening was your idea.
Everyone is always saying what a crazy old maid Emma Goldman I'm becoming. I want to show them how conservative and ignorant I really am.
Oh, you are not conservative. You are not ignorant. And Emma Goldman, believe me, was no old maid.
You know what I mean. Between being what they consider out-and-out anti-American and being over 40 years old and having a beard, you made a grand hit with Mom and Dad, let me tell you.
Oh. I could tell.
Left the house, Dad said. That man is more dangerous than Roosevelt himself.
What they were hoping was that I would be a proper Christian suitor and take Crazy Sally off their hands.
No. At least they've stopped talking that. That's something.
Where are you going? We're getting out of the
way. We are not getting on so bad.
Sally, listen. You're scared. We'll get the real thing to deal with.
There is nothing to deal with.
No, not quite a lot. We can't have it both ways. You can chase me off or you can put on a pretty dress. But you can't put on a pretty dress and come down here and chase me away. I've seen you come home from work, remember? In your uniform.
I changed out of my uniform at work tonight.
Because you thought I'd meet you outside the hospital in spring.
I didn't know you'd be down here. I thought I'd come down here.
You came down here. This is where we came last year.
This is my place. I come down here every day.
On the boathouse to get away from your family. Maybe have a cigarette to unwind because you know you can't smoke up in the house. Maybe take a nip from a whiskey bottle you keep in yourself.
Oh, stay up there forever. I'm as eager to leave as they are eager to get rid of me.
Well, maybe get an apartment in Springfield. Share with Rachel and Ida, so the three of you have tried to work every
day. They're nice girls.
They're very nice. Maybe get a dog, a dachshund maybe. Name him Matt. Smoke all you want. Go to the movies on Saturday nights. Maybe go to some of the USO get-togethers. Don't get too involved with any of the boys. Not Sally.
Is that bad?
No, ma'am, it is bad. You do good work at the hospital. All the boys say they like you best. All those other nurses, though, with their eyes, they were saying, don't go away, Matt. Sally's got to come around.
Enjoy the game.
Yeah, me too. But they were not telling me to go
well,
away.
Well, then I'm telling you to go. Nothing.
See, they could tell that I was in love with you. And they were telling me that you might be in love with me. And wouldn't that be a catastrophe?
I don't think I even know what that means. I don't know if you know.
Aside from that, though, you're afraid you might love me.
I don't even think that's a desirable state to be.
Oh, agreed. 100%. All you have to say is, no, I am not.
Why don't you just leave and make us all happier?
Is that what leaving would make you happy? It wouldn't make me happier. It would be easier. See, I can take no for an answer. What I can't take is evasion. What I can't take is I'm scared. What I can't take is hiding in the kitchen.
Just put it out of your mind, Matt. It's impossible.
solution was... She don't want nothing to do with this Jew type.
It don't matter that she never saw one before. She's heard a great much about them.
There's always being chased from place to place. Must be something wrong.
Anyway, Chick says they're normal breeds and believe everything they hear.
You don't believe that at all. I'm a liberal Midwestern college graduate. You're very exotic to me. I reread the Old Testament.
Well, I hate the solution, but I did not reread the New Testament. So, is that that? Everything must be laid out on the list for me or I get confused. So, one man says, maybe the reason Sally is so scared is it's this German she got to buy. All the boys are off fighting these German types and there's one right here in the middle.
There are old families of German descent here.
Ha ha, you know nothing about this breed.
Might be anybody, huh? Maybe the enemy infiltrate the whole bunch, huh?
That's
handstand for your breath? No, no.
Whistler. He should see what is happening in his boathouse. He'd see una partiva lagrima.
Yeah, he's too good to make the place for me. I was little when he died, but I thought he knew I'd come along, so he built it just the way it is. Falling down, the way people used to build Roman rooms for their gardens. That way, nobody else would come here and discover the magic place.
Falling down, even then?
Well, it wasn't that long ago. I played in it when I was 8 or 10, 27 now.
No, you got wrong.
I'm what?
You're 31.
I am certainly not.
Oh, my God, she does have a vanity as well as a temper. You are 31 because you got fired from teaching Sunday school on your 28th birthday.
What?
And that was 3 years ago.
I've become great friends with your Aunt Charlotte.
You're infiltrated. Your ambush has come up on you from behind.
When did you talk to Aunt Charlotte?
Last year. For a second today. And every few weeks during the winter on the telephone. I had never heard of anybody being fired for Sunday school before.
I quit. We didn't get along.
Oh, I like it better the way she told me. The preacher told you should be teaching from the Methodist reader, not from Thorsten Bell.
Oh, they were having problems with union organizers at the garment factory.
And some of the kids' mothers worked there.
They asked me what was happening.
I like that. So you read to them from?
The Theory of the Leisure Class.
How much of the garment factory did your family own?
Almost 25%. Dad and the minister and the newspaper editor suggested we all concentrate on the does not work, neither shall he eat.
Oh, and scare the pants off the sluggards.
Make these unreligious infidels buckle down.
Be good Christian workers.
I also read from St. Augustine.
Profit is a sin.
Businessmen will never enter the kingdom.
He was also a terrible anti-Semite.
Words, he was Catholic.
Now, Sam, you know that unmarried daughters are supposed to help the menfolk keep the social status quo.
Oh, there was a time when Dad had great hopes for me.
No wonder they are so eager to get you out of their house.
You're older than I am.
More than you know. I'm 42.
That's about what I imagined.
So this guy the other day. I eat in a cafeteria. I talk to a lot of nutty people.
I don't want to hear another
story. No, it's not like that. I came down here to tell you this. This guy said we were eggs.
Who? You and me?
All people. Said people are eggs. So we would be very careful not to bang up against each other too hard. Crack our shells. Never be of any use again.
But we were eggs.
Individuals. Had to keep separate. Private. Said nobody ever knows what the other guy is really thinking. We all got about 10 tracks going on at one time. And nobody ever knows what's going down at any given track at any given moment. So we can never really communicate. When I'm talking to you down on track number 3, on track number 5, I could be thinking about overruling words. And when I think you're listening, what are you really thinking?
And you think he's right, or you think he's wrong?
Well, that's two ways of looking at it. I told him he was parallel. Ought not worry too much about being understood. Ought to work at it. We got our work cut out for us, don't we? I told him that he ought to.
What?
Well, it's all right there as an analogy, ain't it? What good is an egg? Gotta be hatched or boiled or mixed up with a lot of other eggs. Then you're cooking. I told him he ought not worry too much about getting his yolk broke.
Where were you born?
He didn't appreciate you.
Why are you being such a private person, such an egg?
nitrogen was not used in the fields as fertilizer. This nitrogen was used in the manufacture of gunpowder. So one should be very careful what one's friends tell you in the cafe. So, the French torture the Prussian, who, being Prussian and Jewish, says nothing, and the French decide to torture the lad's daughter to make the Prussian. The consequences being that the lad's daughter fell into a coma from which she did not recover. And the French were convinced they had the wrong Prussian, you flatulent, and let the whole lot of them go. So they went to the authorities in Germany, leaving a little bit behind with his uncle in Lubeck. The irony turned out to be that the German government reasoned that this gregarious Prussian engineer do something vital to the interest of the Kaiser. Well, as he did. So, the Prussian and the U tried to slip across the border into Denmark. But we understand they forgot to say may I.
They wouldn't kill their own people just because they knew something they might or might not
have. Well, they didn't consider them their own, of course. And people were not killed in Germany. They were indefinitely detained.
I never heard that there were persecutions during the First World War.
I thought you said you reread the Old Testament.
Well, how did he get to America, the lid?
Who said he came to America?
How did he get to America?
Norway to Caracas to America on a banana boat!
By himself or with refugees?
Refugees, refugees. Came with his uncle from Lubeck and his wife and four kids.
Little kids?
What difference does it make what size kids? No, grown people, not little kids. There's always something thrilling about the broad canvas of the European story, isn't there? But unfortunately, the probable end is too much. No allegiances would claim them anymore. No causes.
So the good fall into the army.
Oh, war. What did they know except war? War was life. Life was war. Against the French, you almost would have gone this time. Such a resolve. Well, he doesn't think about it. Life is going to be interesting with you. You are hurt?
No.
My hand is bleeding. Where'd you find that alcohol? I called my uncle and my aunt. 70 years old, they said, Matthew, do not get mixed up with the goyim. I have old cousins, neighbors I haven't heard from in years. I tell them all I've got to live my own life. I come down here picking from death as I'm getting rabies from an old boy.
Why did you tell me about your family and about you?
Because you asked me. Why have you not married? Where were you born? How did you get to this stupid country? Because I'm a crazy person. All of your nurse friends tell you something wacky with Matt, that he's not made a fool of himself over some woman. I said that. Go down, tell Staley who you are for once in your life. Risk something. At least you will know that you did what you could. What do you think she's going to do? Fight you? One does not necessarily follow
the
other.
She doesn't gossip about me. She didn't tell you anything.
So you tell her. No. Charlotte told me nothing. Except there was something to tell. I said, Charlotte, Sherlock thinks that there's some dark mystery down here. And Charlotte said, Mr. Holmes, Sally looked to be his accent.
There is nothing to tell!
You just run to the house of the sheriff because there's no... Oh my God, they could be coming down here right now!
They're all listening to the radio.
Saved by Miss Fanny Bryce. We stick together. Don't know where to begin. I am walking into an unfriendly church in my other drawers here.
Cool.
want to change the subject?
A what?
A fader. A fader. Your brother fakes people. Buddy believes that if all the factory workers went on strike for better wages than they're trying to do in his factory, it would bring the country to its knees. He's a very poetic speaker.
Well, it would bring Buddy to his knees, and that's a position with which he is very unfamiliar, believe me.
What are you
people
afraid
are working now, at least.
Economics, you want to talk? I come down here and I say to you, this is my life. This is what I want. Say no or say yes, and you say talk economics?
Well, will there really be strikes after the war's over?
You're playing games, yes?
I don't know.
You're a peach. Yes, they will strike. People say, shaking in their boots, they will strike. Everybody from soda jerks to grease monkeys. It gives them the illusion the system is working.
People are afraid to admit it, but I think they're worried about what's going to happen when the boys come back.
Down here, they're afraid to admit. I'm glad to hear it shows humility. Humility is good for the soul. In St. Louis, they tremble in their beds at night. Headlines in the paper. One businessman said that the war had lasted another 2 years or the nation would never recover.
They're afraid that there would be another depression.
They won't.
They won't ever mean what
they said. Yeah, I know, since they said they're all lying.
I see it happening all over again. The depression.
No. I am utterly ignorant. On girls, I am more than ignorant. On money, I am an expert only. On taxes, I am an authority. Businesses ask me about taxes. People who cry depression are blind and frightened.
Why should it be different this time?
You are worried?
Yes.
About what's going to be?
It was no fun. Hobos come into the back door 4 and 5 at a time every day, asking for work.
It won't be like that. It won't happen again. Roosevelt himself will be handing out the lollipops.
No wonder acting like
how much money do you save? You're an average person in a less than average job. How much have you saved? You got to spend it on it. You put it in savings account. You buy bonds to save capitalism or democracy or freedom of speech where you're not terrified to express yourself. How much have you saved?
That's wrong. I'm not going
to forget
it.
How much? So how much?
Half my check every week for 3 years.
Uh-huh.
I make $30 a week.
$2,340.
A little less.
Multiply that times 120
million. You're a mathematician. What does it come to?
A lot of money that nobody had before the war. Burning a hole in everybody's pocket. How many people bought war bonds? 85 million people. How much money is in savings accounts? $130 billion. Everybody will be building and spending and working. Sideshow is over. End of financial exhibition.
Like generalization like that.
Oh. I forget the gasoline,
you're
don't you think?
You're not out of gas.
Well, maybe I am. Maybe I lied.
Well, if that's what it takes.
You know what I'm thinking over on track number 9? Sally may not be who I thought she was after all.
Maybe not.
May not be. Maybe not. What kind of an answer to a mystery is that? What happened to change this golden girl into an embarrassment to the family? Into a radical old maid who gets fired for teaching Sunday school? Why would this nice Harley leave you after all those years when you were sick with such a romantic disease? See, I'm a logical person. I have to have everything all laid out like in a list. And that isn't logical.
His family didn't want him to marry me, obviously.
Because they thought you weren't good enough for him.
What? Yes, don't do that.
Mr. Campbell was in debt, worried about being overextended, but the rich partner's daughter gets TV and the wedding is up.
No.
There's your music. Wasn't Harley the richest boy in town, you said?
Yes.
And Sally was the richest girl in the countryside. This was the match of a decade. Bells were going to ring for such a match.
Well, they didn't.
When the depression comes, rich families must pool their resources.
They didn't see it that way.
The Harleys are, the Campbells are a large Missouri family, are they, with 15 little Campbells?
No.
No, only Harley, 2 brothers and a sister.
No.
No, only Harley and his brother.
Harley and his sister.
Harley was the only son of a prominent Lee County family.
Yes.
So why did they want this only son to marry the beautiful, popular, cheerleader Kelly girl? They'd be going to stay with for 3 years.
They didn't like me.
And he saw you all those years over their protest?
Not in your life.
No, because Harley didn't do anything to get his parents'
no.
wishes. But in fact, you didn't graduate with Harley. You were delayed a full year.
That's beginning to hurt, Matt.
You're pulling. I'm not pulling. Why weren't you good enough for Harley?
I got sick.
Oh. You got TB in Winnowaty, Arizona, where you live the rest of your life.
No.
Oh, you gave this contagious disease to their only son, and he went away to Arizona, never to be heard from again.
The TB was not serious. There were complicating circumstances that caused me to be out of school.
There were complications. Sally was pockmarked and ugly. Nobody wanted anything to do with her.
I'd say that.
This only son was repulsed by the sight of
her. No, Matt. I was in the hospital for a month. I had a fever.
This Harley had a morbid fear of hospitals? I'm getting a fever.
Either.
You were pale and white, wouldn't look good in a wedding dress.
Matt.
You were a tramp and a battler, a ruined reputation of this prominent family.
He was the heir. He had to carry on the family name.
You were irresponsible. You had uncontrollable kleptomania. Could be traveling around the family
flight. I had a fever.
went there, I was terribly unhappy, and I knew I was unhappy. I had fallen in love with a girl, and I could not give her what she would surely.